100%, so I'm gonna try and do this not too quickly, but like I'm just gonna try and get it done. But if it cuts off and I continue it later and it's all different, now you know why. Okay, so I've got 14 questions. And the first one is, who's your favorite musical artist? By the way, these questions are all like so different. But the first few are pretty like similar. Anyway, who's your favorite musical artist? Honestly, I don't have one. If I had to pick, I love Rihanna, but like I do love her as a musical artist, but as a business like entrepreneur, I think she's amazing. I do love her music though. I still listen to it. I mean, how could you not? It's so good. I really, really, really like Doja Cat. But I also listen to a lot of like throwbacks, I guess. So like I will listen to like I will in the car I will listen to like Maroon 5, like old Maroon 5, and like Since You've Been Gone, Kelly Clarkson, and just like fun music because they put me in the best mood. Yeah, I don't really have a favorite musical artist. I can't even think of anyone besides Rihanna right now. Maybe I should have thought about this before I started the video. I do love Ariana Grande as well, but I wouldn't say she's my favorite. What's your motivation to start an ASMR channel? So, if you're new here and don't know why I started this channel in July last year, so July 2020, and I started it because I got sick last year on March 1st. So March 1st, 2020, I got sick, and it has been a long journey trying to get diagnosed and everything. Since then, I've been diagnosed with Crohn's, but I originally started the channel as a stress relief for myself, which has worked tremendously. And then at the same time, I've been helping you guys relax, and then, I don't know, it just kind of grew a little bit from that. So, yeah, as you can, like, if you scroll down through my videos, you'll see, like, I'm looking healthier now in my more recent videos, but you can tell there's some pretty it's like not bad looking, but like you can just tell there's something wrong with my health in some of my older videos. But yeah, so sorry if you can hear that ringing in the back. It's someone like using their Bluetooth in their car, and so loud. Okay, who's your favorite ASMR artist and why? Okay, I have like four different favorite ASMR artists at the moment. Make that five. So, just recently I've been getting into sporty ASMR, and I think she is amazing. She is so tingly, it's ridiculous. I always, always, always watch ASMR Spring. I love her, like, I love her vibe and her accent, that Jersey accent. I love it. I love watching her like beauty box subscription unboxings. And then I also always watch ASMR Planets. She is like one of the only people that could put me to sleep. It's the like mannequin head videos where she does like the makeup or wooden makeup. Oh my god, that is so good. If you haven't checked that out, you need to. I'm sure you would have though. And then also Sarah Rios, I don't know if that's how you say it, but I love her as well. She is amazing. She has such a cool vibe as well. And then also Rapunzel ASMR when she does the hair treatment, like lice checking things. I love that as well. I think it's so, so tingly. And then favorite ASMR trigger. What's your favorite ASMR trigger? I basically honeybee ASMR when she does like the all the colors that match and everything. And I think my favorite trigger is probably just tapping, like, but with natural nails. I really like tapping. Do you have a plan? Oh, sorry. Do you plan on having any kids in the future? If so, how many? If you asked me this like a couple months ago, I would have said absolutely not. No kids. I don't really even believe in marriage. I want to get engaged one day, but I don't want to get married legally, because we're all, like, my partner and I are already legally together because we're de facto. But anyway, that wasn't the question. Kids. I found out recently that if I was to get pregnant, it'd be a very high risk pregnancy, so I'm at very high risk of not being able to hold the child, the baby, in my body, and it would take like a massive toll on my body, so I don't want kids right now, but maybe one day I might want one. I don't think I would want to put my body through anything more than that, and surrogacy in Australia is so different to surrogacy in the US. In Australia, I'm pretty sure you have to, like, the surrogate has to be a family member, and I don't have any sisters, or, like, I don't have anyone who would hold a child for me, so, yeah. I don't know about that. What is your age? I am 22. I am turning 23 on June 16. What was your favorite subject in school? Oh my god, it has been, like, 5 years since I was in school. Six. I graduated in 2015, and my favorite subject at the time when I was in school, my favorite subject was art. Like, now that I'm looking back at it, I think that my favorite subject was actually English, which is weird because I was so bad at it until grade 12. But yeah, next. We're up to question number 8, by the way. What is your goal in life? I don't think I have like a specific goal. Other than to be happy and comfortable. Obviously, I would love to buy a house, and I would love to, you know, be rich and whatever, but, like, realistically, I know that a lot of rich people are very, very unhappy, so I think my main goal is to be comfortable with who I am and what I'm doing and where I'm at, and just be happy about it, and to stay healthy. As healthy as I can be. So yeah. How did you and your partner meet? Well, so I used to work in Subway when I was like 18, and he worked in the hotel. It was like Q1 hotel, and I worked at the bottom of the hotel, and he used to walk past Subway so much, and I used to think he was so weird. And then one day I went to work after a night out, and I kind of just like ran up to him and I started talking to him, and I literally, at this point, I wasn't even hungover, I was probably still a little bit drunk, and yeah, I went up to him and I had so much confidence, and I just started talking with him, and I don't know, it just something sparked, and yeah, he's decided to come into the store at times, and like, I would clean the glass, and he would touch the glass right after I'd clean it, which is, if you work in food, it is, how annoying is that, when you clean the glass, and then someone touches the glass, and gets fingerprints all over it, like, no. So then, after that, he didn't, like, look for me on Facebook or anything, and like, I don't know about you, but I'm like, I would have just, like, looked up his, not even what I did, I just looked up his name badge, like, his name, his real name's Cody, so I looked up Cody, Q1, like, where he was. except me, and then we just started talking, and we just hit it off, and literally, I don't know, we just started talking, and then I'm not one to have, like, one-off things with people, so I made him take me out on a date, and he took me to the place where we went for Valentine's Day, the Hurricane's Grill, which is where we get ribs, and I had ribs on our first date. I don't, like, I'm not gonna be that girl that goes out and gets salad, like, I'm gonna get, like, the fattest piece of meat you can get. I don't know. Yeah, anyway. So, I got that, and I'm pretty sure when I was eating the ribs, that was when he fell in love with me, and then I offered to pay, and then he ended up paying, and then yeah, I don't know, ever since then, we just literally didn't stop seeing each other. I wasn't wearing a wig and like a full face of makeup, because right now, like, mask on, but you guys have seen me without makeup in my other videos, and I love myself without makeup or with makeup. Like, it doesn't bother me, and it took me a very, very, very long time for me to get to the point where I love myself without makeup, where I love my skin, and just, like, I'm comfortable with myself. I think I was probably, like, 20 when it happened, and it probably was, like, maybe actually 21. So, yeah. It takes time. It is not something that's gonna happen overnight, and you can't really force it, but I would suggest giving yourself a lot of self-love, you know, positive affirmations in the morning when you look in the mirror. Don't be like, oh my god, why are my hips like that? Oh my god, why is my tummy like that? Because tummies are normal. Tummies are so normal. Body positivity is like such a crazy thing because we have Instagram, which is telling everyone you need to be slim, thick, and everything, but it's like, that's not realistic. It's not. And if it's like your face and you're looking in the mirror and you're looking at your face and you're like, why does my chin look that like that? Why does my nose look like that? Everyone is perfect. Literally, like, I can't even explain that enough. Like, I hate beauty standards so much. But then when I say that, I feel like I'm being the biggest hypocrite because I'm wearing a wig and full face of makeup right now. But it takes time, and it's like, just do what makes you feel good. Like, if you like skincare, go find the skincare that works perfectly for you. I know it costs money, so maybe save up for it if you don't have the money there to spend. Or like retail therapy. Like, when I am feeling down, I always do online shopping, even if it's literally like online window shopping where I add things to my cart, screenshot it, and then never buy it. I don't know, I just feel better, like releasing that energy into me wanting to spoil myself. I hope this makes sense. It's all about self-love, and if you're feeling insecure, it's pretty normal. I mean, I still feel insecure a lot sometimes, but at the end of the day, I do love myself and who I am, and I don't know, I just, it's taken me a very, very long time for that. This has been the hardest question to answer so far. I'm just gonna move on to the next, which is the last one. Is there a certain age or time in life anyone should keep in mind if they ever want to be in some sort of relationship? No. Like, I don't know how old you are asking this question, but if you're like, no, just simple answer, no. You should always put yourself first, you know, like, focus on yourself and your happiness before you do anything, because it's so cliche and everyone says it, but it's so true. You can't love someone else properly unless you love yourself first, and you can't expect someone to love you if you don't love yourself. Does that make sense? I hope it does. There's no age time limit on love. I mean, when I was like 16, I got my first boyfriend, and I look back at it now and I'm like, I feel like I was peer pressured into like being in a relationship because of all the social standards. When I look back at it, I'm like, that wasn't real love. Like, that is nothing like what I'm experiencing these days. So there's definitely not. And if you are at uni, honestly, focus on your studies and yourself, and I swear, once you stop looking, someone comes into your life. It's so weird how life works like that, but I swear most of the times it does, but obviously it might not. But yeah, there's no age limit, there's no time, no certain time. I know a lot of people get married in their like has to do. It's all up to your, first of all, personal preference, and then also if you find someone, because you might not meet your soulmate until you're 50, and there's nothing wrong with that. So yeah, this turned out to be a long video. I hope you enjoyed it. That is all the questions in this book. See you guys in my next video. I hope you enjoyed this one.